Hi guys, this is Zen and you're watching Zen Techie Learning, and this is a Windows Server tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to install the VMware machine on the Windows system. So I will talk about how to install it and what are the prerequisites for the VMware virtual machine. So these are all the things we are going to discuss in this tutorial. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So guys, first of all, what you need to do, you need to understand the VMware, why do we need that? And how you can install the virtual machine on the Windows system. So I'm going to explain each and every bit of it. So first of all, you need to understand the prerequisite for the virtual machine. So virtual machine, if you want to download the VMware, so you have to go to the Google and just type VMware Workstation Pro 16. The latest version is 16. Just hit the enter and you will see this particular page. And on this particular page, you need to just click on this link, the first link, download VMware Workstation Pro. And so basically, here we go. So we have the information here, Workstation 16 Pro. So for that, if you want to know the prerequisite and the details, so for that you have to go to the the more details, and you can get the details like what should be the specification of your machine. But if I want to give you a quick overview, so at least your machine should be a 8 gig of RAM. There should be a at least i3 processor, and there should be a the 100 gig of space in your hard drive at least. Then after, you can install the VMware workstation on your machine. So simply you have to hit on this particular icon. Let me show you up again. Download now. When you hit the download now, the download will start it. And after that, you need to decide where you want to save it. I want to save it to the to this folder, download folder, and I want to click on save. Now the download has been started here. It might take for a while. It depends upon your internet speed, how your internet is working. And so you have to wait a little bit. So in the meanwhile, would like to explain you a few things more. After doing the installation of the VMware Workstation Pro 16 on your machine, you can create a virtual machine. So initially you need to create a the client virtual machine for the client operating system. Another, you have to create a virtual machine for the Windows Server operating system. And that is, these all the things we'll discuss later on in the next tutorial. So stay tuned. Now for that purpose, you can do one thing. You can subscribe our channel, and please do motivate us. Please do like and comment whatever you need, whatever you want to learn, and whatever your concern, you can mention in the comment section also. So it is almost there. My speed is pretty much good, I guess. It's not that much good, but it's obviously it's good. I mean, I'm pretty much satisfied with the speed. So 11 seconds left, 9 seconds, 8 seconds. So simply, it's a very simple process. I mean, no need to do any, like, it's not like a very difficult task. It's a very simple, a few steps, then you can go inside the virtual machine. So the download has been completed. I'm just going to the folder. Yeah, here we go. So the download file is right here. I'm going to right click on it. When you right click and then just click on, either you can click on open or run as administrator, both are fine. So either you can just double click, left double click on it, and it will be opened. So please wait. All right, you have to click on yes. There will be a pop-up where you have to click on yes. Maybe it could not be captured in the screen, but there was a pop-up where it was asking your permission. So you have to click on yes. And then the Workstation Pro 16 is in a progress. It is a way to installation. And it will be preparing each and every steps, and might take a few seconds more. And then it will be all yours. Preparing VMware Workstation for the installation. And I would say it's a very good software. I have used it. I mean, I have basically, I could remember the when I started my preparation on Windows Server, the Wintel session, when I was doing the Wintel session. Wintel is a session related to client and server. When I was doing for that, I used to learn on Hypervisor and VMware. But VMware is a good, I mean, I would say. If you are learning anything related to technology, and if you want to learn new technologies, then please do mention in a comment section which all the technologies you want to get a hands-on experience. I will definitely give you a tutorial regarding that. So I'm going to click on next. I'm going to accept all the term and condition. Next. And it is asking some kind of permissions. I'm going to click on next and then click on next. Desktop, all right, no issue. Next, then installation. All right, so this is how the installation is getting done. Please wait while Setup Wizard installs VMware Workstation Pro. So it might ask you the license key, because generally you get the trial version for the 30 days, so you can use it for the 30 days, and after the 30 days you can uninstall or reinstall it again, or else you can buy the license. If you want to know the trick, I'm not going to tell you how you can make it lifetime free. And what do you want to have for a lifetime, then either you can buy a license or All right, so it is almost there, and it is asking me to license. I'm going to click on licensing, then it will be asking for the key. If you are not going to provide the key, then it will be there for the 30 days trial period, and after that it will be expired. So you have to make it as per your choice. All right, so I'm going to skip that and then click on finish. That's it. So VMware installation has been done on my machine. I'm just going to click on this, and it will be open. Let me show you up how that looks like, and how to create the virtual machine. These are the things I will let you know later on. So let me just click on this. Yes. Finish. All right, here we go. So this is your virtual machine, where you can create a virtual machine, and I will discuss about how you can create the virtual machine in the next tutorial. So stay tuned, and thank you so much for watching this video, and have a wonderful day ahead. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care.